Good morning, everyone. It's nice to see you all. It's nice to have new carpet. We haven't been here, of course. We were gone for 2 Sundays. But we're happy to be back. It's really nice to be back. And thank you for your thoughts and prayers. In the spring, as many of you know, in the spring and fall, John and I take 2 weeks vacation. And we were blessed to go to Switzerland in the last 2 weeks. And so, but I'm not going to share all kinds of pictures at the beginning, but I am going to share them because they all become part of the service today. Because we have a special service, it's all about the Psalms. Isn't that cool? I mean, all of us love the Psalms. At least all of us have one favorite Psalm, maybe. Psalm 23. My mother's favorite Psalm was this one. I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. She's enjoying that in heaven now. And before I forget, if you haven't gotten your October, November, December, there's some out there, they're all over the place. I know a number of you get those in the mail or get them delivered as well. And so John said to me, why don't you include one of our great mountain pictures in the opening? And I said, yeah, but I want to do one better. I wanted to do a real short video of this. This is the highest mountain in Europe. We are in Switzerland, but we crossed over into France. And it's like just going over into Wisconsin, literally. So I know some of you have been there. Talked to Paul this morning, talked to Ruth this morning. Both of them have been to Switzerland. I'm sure some of you, Sally, was there. This is the highest mountain in Europe. It's over 3 miles high. It's Mont Blanc in France. And so I just wanted to, I'm going to not play any sound because the wind and everything. I'm just going to show you, this is 28 seconds. And we took 3 gondolas to get up here, 15,700 feet. You couldn't even breathe very well, but you had to go really slow to enjoy it. So here's just a real short video. Because we lift our eyes up in the hills of the mountains. So here it is. The gondola went all the way up to the top there. And it goes down. Yeah, I know. You're thinking, why would you take a gondola up that high, right? Yeah. And then you can see people hiking right there. You see that little guy hiking down the mountain? Not all of you could probably see it, but I just wanted to share that. There's snow everywhere. It's unbelievably beautiful. And God gave us a perfect day. So let us lift our eyes up on the hills from whence comes our help today. And all of the things we do today, all the songs, all the scripture, everything is from the Psalms. So God bless us as we continue. The book of Psalms was written to help us worship God. It teaches us today and night, meditate upon God's word. And it provides an enormous amount of material to use in that time of private worship and reflection. Regardless of any life situation, whether it be betrayal or victory, deep loss or joyful gain, a time of confusion or a time of celebration, there is an appropriate psalm for that season. So we continue in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We first take a look at undoubtedly the most well-known psalm, Psalm 23. David faced great suffering when he wrote this psalm. He truly felt as though he were walking through the valley of the shadow of death as he was pursued by his enemies who sought to kill him. But he took comfort in this. Regardless of his earthly circumstances, he would dwell in the house of the Lord for all eternity. Let us join our voices with David as we sing Psalm 23. So he does restore. Another major theme of the Psalms is life is hard, but God is good. All of God's saints throughout the ages have dealt with difficulties to varying degrees. Those who composed the Psalms were no exception. They had enemies, Psalm 3, verse 7. They felt forgotten and anxious, Psalm 13. They dealt with lies and deception, Psalm 12. And sensed that God had abandoned them, Psalm 22. Yet this was no reason to stop praising. God is a deliverer, Psalm 37, and he would be faithful, so it is always right to praise him. As we too cry out to the Lord, we will use Psalm 51 as our confession. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love. According to your great compassion, blot out my transgressions. Wash away all my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is always before me. Against you, you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Surely I was sinful at birth, sinful from the time my mother conceived me. Yet you desired faithfulness even in the womb. You taught me wisdom in that secret place. Cleanse me with hyssop, and I will be clean. Wash me, and I will be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones you have crushed be rejoiced. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquity. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me from your presence, or take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and grant me a willing spirit to sustain me. We'll sing from Psalm 51. We'll sing it through once and then repeat the second verse, cast me not away. Amen. All of your sins are forgiven in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We have a beautiful psalm. We continue Psalm 42. And as the deer panteth for the living waters, so our soul panteth for God, which we'll sing in just a minute. As the deer pants for streams of water, so my soul pants for you, my God.
My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When can I go and meet with God?
My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me all day long, where is your God?
These things I remember, how I used to go to the house of God under the protection of the mighty one, with shouts of joy.
He lifted me out of the slimy pit. out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. He put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will see and fear the Lord and put their trust in Him. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, who does not look to the proud, those who turn aside to false gods. Many, Lord, my God, are the wonders you have done, the things you plan for us. None can compare with you. Were I to speak and tell of your deeds, there would be too many to declare. Sacrifice and offering you do not desire, but my ears you have opened. Burnt offerings and sin offerings you do not require. Then I said, here I am, I have come. It is written about me in the scroll. I desire to do your will, my God. Your law is within my heart. I proclaim your saving acts in the great assembly. I do not seal my lips, Lord, as you know. I do not hide your righteousness in my heart. I speak of your faithfulness and saving help. I do not conceal your love and your faithfulness from your great assembly. Do not withhold your mercy from me, Lord. May your love and faithfulness always protect me. For troubles without number surround me. My sins have overtaken me, and I cannot see. They are more than the hairs of my head, and my heart fails within me. Be pleased to save me, Lord. Come quickly, Lord, to help me. May all who want to take my life be put to shame and confusion. May all who desire my ruin be turned back in disgrace. May those who say to me, aha, aha, be appalled at their own shame. But may all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who long for your saving help always say, the Lord is great. But as for me, I am poor and needy. May the Lord think of me. You are my help and my deliverer. You are my God. Do not delay. This is a song by Lenny and Mary. We'll just listen to it as we follow along. Yeah, you're patiently waiting. Thank you. That's right. Come on, Jesus. Work it out. I got it. It worked so good before worship today. Start over here. Thank you for waiting. Jesus never had struggled with these technical issues, but that's okay. He had that beautiful Sea of Galilee behind him, and he could just project out as well. But it's all about trusting in the Lord, isn't it? Even when we're waiting patiently. So let's pray. Thank you, Jesus, for working things out. Thank you for working through everything, Lord, not just some things. And thank you, Lord, for rescuing each one of us, not only rescuing us when we're sinking, but then giving us a new place to stand, planting our feet on solid ground, bringing people into our lives who are like rocks to us that strengthen us, and then giving us the joy and praise to share what you've done with us with others. Bless that time, Lord, and equip us for that task today and this week. Through your words, we pray. Amen. Amen. Yeah, oh my gosh, the Psalms. I'm giving you a really quick little background here from Psalms. You probably know this, but it's so cool to me, I think of it. Just briefly, this one short slide. If you look at the very bottom, about 1,000 years, the Psalms were compiled over 1,000 years. From the time of Moses, Moses even wrote one of the Psalms, 1,400 years before Christ, all the way to 400 years before Christ, right? And maybe you don't know this, but it's divided into 5 books. And each book corresponds with the 5 books of Moses, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus. So, for instance, if you look in the center there, the Pentateuch, the 5 books, Book 1, which is 1 to 41, is Genesis and creation. Exodus, Book 2, Leviticus, worship. 3, Numbers, wilderness. And Deuteronomy, scripture and praise. So I really like that. And then also it shows that who compiled these? You know, King David, you know, certainly. Hezekiah, Josiah, Ezra, and Nehemiah. If you remember Ezra and Nehemiah, they came back from Babylon and they rebuilt the temple. 450 years before Christ. So they also added to the Psalms. Isn't that great? So why is Psalm 40 my favorite song? Psalm? I had to ask myself, I've never asked myself that question really before, and I came up this week with 3 things. Because it perfectly illustrates the life of all believers in Christ. Number one, what we've all been through, you know, quicksand, sinking sand, slimy pits. And I know some of you are still in the midst of that right now. I've talked to some people this week, people, friends who will be listening to these words, God willing, this week, who are feeling like they're sinking in quicksand right now. You know, it's like, Lord, what we've been through, how we have been rescued, number two. And number three, how we share our new life in Christ with others. And again, don't take my word for it. The opening, what does it say? What we've been through and how we've been rescued. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. Number one. Number two, he set my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. I love that. This picture is a little more descriptive. There you go. Right? Here we go. We're sinking. It's like, oh my gosh. If I go all the way under, I will suffocate from the mud and all that I'm going through in my life. But here the Lord reaches in. He lifts me out of the slimy pit. He sets my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. And I thought of this, and I remember when I first experienced this, Joan and I had the best friends of our lives back in the seminary in St. Louis, Steve and Jane. And they lived near us later. They lived now in Rochester. And I remember visiting with them and having Bible study. And every time we visited, I felt solid. I felt like rock. And I thought, wow, that's what that means, you know? Jesus is the rock. We used to sing a song, Jesus is the Rock in the World by Louis Lee. It's a great song, yeah, by the way. And so he's the rock that we build on. So I have one other really quick little video here. Joan and I, we went to the highest place there on that mountain, the highest in Europe. There's a theater there, the cinema theater, and it shows all these people hiking, risking their lives. And it brought me to tears because when they get to the summit of those mountains, you know what they find on the top of the summit? They find a cross with Christ on it. And then they reach out and touch it. It's like, thank you, Jesus, even if they don't believe. And so I'm going to play this really quick one, and it's really kind of grainy, I think. You'll get a feel for watch them at the very end as they touch the cross when they make it to the top. It's so crazy. It's like, why would anybody ever do this? They're coming to the top of this rock. And notice on the very, very top when they get there, there's a cross and there's a crucifix on it right there. And they reach out. And I thought, oh my gosh, isn't that the story of our lives as Christians? Right? So then when we got to the top, this is hard to believe, but we got to the top of the highest mountain in Europe, and guess what was there? There's Jesus, a crucifix of Christ, covered with like 5 inches of ice. Really kind of strange, and I just joked at first, saying, oh my gosh, it's bad enough that Jesus had to be crucified, and now he's covered with 6 inches of ice up there. But that's what they have on the top, and then I thought, no, the resurrection melted the ice, right? And then you notice there's a plaque underneath, and I looked at that plaque. It's in German. It took me about 15 minutes to translate this. And guess what? When I translated it yesterday, it was a song. Isn't that great? Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, the mountain of his holiness, beautiful for situation, the joy of the earth, is Mount Zion on the sides of the north, the city of the great king. And I bet some of you learned this song, singing it. All the songs have music to them. When I get to heaven, I'm going to say, hey, David, I love Psalm 23. Is this the tune that you use? This will be used on Sunday morning. And so the one I learned here, some of you know, it goes, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness, beautiful for situation, the joy of the whole earth, is Mount Zion on the sides of the north, the city of the great king. So all the songs have music to them, which I love. And while I was on the mountaintop, the highest point in Europe, I grabbed a rock. Here's the rock. And this isn't quite as cool as the rock that Joan and I got and gave to Janine. Because whenever we go anywhere, we get sand and rocks and everything for Janine. And she collects those things. And that's really biblical. Because in the Bible, Joshua, when he went over brought the children to the promised land, he took the stones and built an altar of remembrance. And Jacob, when he had the vision of angels in Bethel, he picked up the rocks and he built an altar of remembrance, a memorial altar as well. And so Psalm 18, this is so great. King David, he sang to the Lord the words of his song, and the Lord delivered him from the hand of his enemies and from the hand of Saul. And what did he say? The Lord is my rock, my fortress, my deliverer, my God, my rock, whom I take refuge. And then notice the last verse. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and may the God of my salvation be exalted. I bet some of you learned this song. It goes, the Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of my salvation be exalted. I mean, all these songs from Christian camp, from Sunday school, from prayer and praise services. But who is the rock? Well, Paul in 1 Corinthians, it's kind of mysterious. But Paul writes, in the wilderness, the children of Israel, they were all baptized in Moses in the cloud. And in the sea, they all ate the same spiritual food and drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them, and that rock was Christ. Interesting. So when God asked Moses to speak to the rock, and Moses got so frustrated that he beat the rock with his rod for the water to come out, that was part of the reason why he was not allowed to enter into the promised land. Think about it. Christ, the rock, being beaten instead of just dialogue and spoken to. And then Psalm 118, the famous psalm, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. The Lord has done this very day. That's Psalm 118, verse 22. Two verses later, Psalm 118, verse 24, is this. This is the day, right? We all sing, the day the Lord let us rejoice and be glad in it. And who remembers the fun fact of Psalm 118, verse 24? That's really important. Anyone? It's kind of a side note. I've said it a lot of times. I was going to say, Joe, you can't answer this. If you take all those words of the whole Bible from Genesis to Revelation, and you find the very center paragraph of the whole Bible, it's Psalm 118. It's right here. Blessed be the Lord. But again, don't take my words. It's not just my word, it's Jesus' words. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. Because in Matthew's Gospel 21, what did Jesus say? He said, have you never read in the scriptures, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it's marvelous. So when you build a building, the cornerstone that holds everything together, right, is Christ. It's middle C on the piano that everything is tuned to is in C for Christ as well. So that's Jesus saying, don't reject the living stone here. And then Peter, before he died, he continued on this theme. I tell you, the Holy Spirit is running with us, the rock theme today. He talks about being built up as living stones, Peter. And I won't read all of it, but just the opening paragraph. Peter writes, come to him as a living stone to which has been rejected by people, but is a choice and precious in the sight of God. You also, as living stones, are being built up into a spiritual house for a holy priesthood to offer spiritual sacrifices that are acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. And it goes on, I'm laying this choice stone. So isn't that great? Peter writes, we're all living stones here, aren't we? We're being built up in this beautiful altar. So the third point of mine, why I love this song, we share Christ with others. It goes on to say, he put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise toward God. Many will see and fear the Lord and put their trust in him. And as the song continues, it even gets better. This is what David says. He wants us to go public. Psalm 40. I proclaim righteousness in the great assembly. I do not seal my lips, as you know, O Lord. I do not hide your righteousness in my heart. I speak of your faithfulness and salvation. I do not conceal your love and your truth from the great assembly. Right? Praise God. I've said this quite often. The reason we're here today is because God is equipping us after he's forgiven us, and he sends us out to share what we've learned. If you remember Acts chapter 2, Peter baptizes 3,000. The church is born. Acts chapter 3, Peter heals a man born blind. He says, I don't have silver and gold, but what I have, I give you in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Rise up and walk. Acts 3. And he gets up, and went leaping and dancing and praising God. Another song. That's in Acts chapter 4. Filled with the Spirit, right? And then they told the disciples, you need to shut up. Don't talk about this. Stop doing these healings. Stop talking about Jesus being resurrected. And what did they say? This is what they said. This is what we say. But Peter and John replied, do you think God wants us to obey you rather than him? We could not stop telling about everything we have seen and heard. Isn't that right? How can we stop what God's done for us? So let me close with a famous verse and a short video, a final video part, that relates, I think, so beautifully. We all know this verse. It's not a song, but it is Isaiah 40. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run, not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. So when we got up, we took three young goats to the highest place, mountain here, 15,700 feet, over 3 miles. And at the first level of gondola, Joan and I stopped on the way down. We went hiking, and we saw these people paragliding, jumping off over a mile high. So there, think about this as your faith. Think about this as a story. We could have paid $240 each to have someone beside us jumping over the cliff. And Joan wanted to do that. But I told her I didn't have enough faith to do that. Okay? And you'll see what I mean right here. Maybe some of you will do this. But here we go. So we'll see the video first. And there are two of them together, and they're just getting ready to jump off this cliff. And think about on eagle's wings here as we go. Here we go. They're running as fast as they can, and they're together, tied together, and they just jump off the cliff. And that's not, there's already two more in the air, and watch the next one come. Would you do that for 240 hours? Okay. Yeah, you have more faith than me. And then here comes the next one, watch this now. All of a sudden, watch how fast they go. Oh, they go so fast, and they just run. Praise God. So that's the Spirit raising us up and helping us fly together, right? Amen. So some of us can do that for 240, and some of us will pray for those who are doing it. Amen. We'll continue with our prayers at this time. We have a lot to pray for. And again, before the service, if you have some prayers, let me know ahead of time. Luther shared with me, many of you know Patsy, who is Luther's wife. She's in the hospital this week. She has pulmonary fibrosis, which is a lung disease that can't be healed. And it's really difficult in her breathing as well. And Luther shared with me something really special, that her whole life, she's been married 67 years, and her whole life she's been giving to others. She's given over 25,000 pairs of shoes to the Samaritan's Purse. She's given over 9,000 dolls to places in Africa and beyond. Always giving. And Luther said when she gets to heaven, she's going to be sewing garments for the angels. So God bless you, Luther. Yeah. And we all know there's so many other prayers. Oh my gosh. You know, you almost forget about Ukraine and Russia, don't you? You forget about, you know, there's Gaza, there's Lebanon now. There's an all-out war potential. You know, there's two tornadoes and people being killed all over the place. And then we have this election going on. Oh my gosh, Lord. And you know, whatever happens in the next few weeks of the election, we have to all believe. Some will be super happy, some will be sad, whatever. God still works through everything, doesn't he? Regardless of what we think. And so we just have to trust, even though it might be difficult, as we all know, by faith. So let's pray. Thank you, Jesus, for raising us up on eagle's wings, and thank you for protecting us. Lord, each one of us, in one way or another, has been, and some are right now, sinking in quicksand. But you deliver us, you lift us up, you wash us off in our baptisms. You give us a new place to stand on the rock, which is Jesus Christ, and our faith. And then you just lift us up to be able to share the love of Christ with others. And maybe oftentimes without words, just with our actions. Thank you, Lord, for protecting the service today as well and helping it all get out. Bless us this week, and thank you, Jesus, and all. There's so many prayers we have, and you already know what they are. We include them in the prayer you've taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of His Holy Spirit continue to be and abide by all of us as well. Amen.
I have a little just announcement.
Before the closing hymn?
Yep.
Okay.
If you can stand, it's Pastor Appreciation Day today. If you can stand, you can pastor and his wife.
Thank you. If you can stand, that's fine. So we'll sing this through three times for the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.